to Sumaya English Primary School. Today we will start with the subject English and the class is class 6. And the name of the poem is the Clothes Line. The title of the poem is the Clothes Line. What do you mean by the clothes line? Now we will talk about these things. What do you mean by the clothes line? It's a rope tied to the opposite poles of a tree or wall to hang wet clothes for drying. Here is the first stanza, we will see it. Hand in hand, they dance in a row, hither and thither and to and fro, flip, flap, flop, and away they go, fluttering creatures as white as snow. Now in this poem, the poetess describes the clothes which are hung to dry on the clothesline outside the house in an open area. She says that the clothes on the clothesline seem to dance because of the breeze. The clothes move in different directions, making a flapping noise. That is why she calls them fluttering creatures. The clothes are white and washed so neatly that the poetess describes them as white as snow. This was the explanation of the first stanza. Now next we will go to the second stanza. Like restive horses, they caper and prance. Like fairy tale witches, they wildly dance. Rounded in front but hollow behind, they shiver and skip in the merry March wind. Now what is said in this second stanza, we will see. The clothes are flapping in the breeze so widely that it reminds her of horses who are restless, who do not seem to stay still in a place. They also remind her of witches, of fairy tales, who always keep in dancing wildly on her broom. It is the month of March and the clothes seem to shiver and dance in the cheerful cold wind. This was the stanza of the second stanza. Now next things we will talk about the third stanza. One I saw dancing excitedly, struggling so wildly, till she was free, then leaving pegs and clothes lying behind her. She flew like a bird and no one can find her. Now we will see what in this stanza the poetess is trying to say. The poetess notices that one of the clothes dancing so excitedly and trying hard to free herself from the pegs which is used to serve the clothes on the clothes line, so that they may not fall down. Suddenly at last, the clothes was able to free herself and flew off like a bird, leaving the pegs and the clothesline behind her. Alas, no one could find her. Now the next stanza is the, I saw her gleam like a sail in the sun, flipping and flapping and flopping for more fun. Nobody knows where she now can be, hide in a ditch or drowned in the sea. She was my handkerchief not long ago, but she will never come back to my pocket, I know. The fourth stanza says that the poetess saw her shine like a sail in the sun and flapping away happily. Nobody knows where she is now, whether she is hiding in a pit at the side of the road or filled or got drowned in the sea. Do you know, children, that the piece of the cloth was her handkerchief? The poetess knows very well and sure that she will never get back her handkerchief again. So this was the fourth stanza. I hope so all the stanzas was cleared. Thank you very much.